Hello everyone. Today we will discuss about the mechanism of action of group 2 hormones. Group 2 hormones are hydrophilic in nature. These are hydrophilic in nature and these hormones bind to cell surface receptors. Cell surface receptors. And this causes the release of second messengers. And this second messenger will perform the biochemical function. So these are hydrophilic in nature and these bind to cell surface receptors and causes the release of second messengers. And this second messengers will perform the biochemical function. This type of mechanism of action is known as fixed membrane receptor mechanism. Fixed membrane receptor mechanism or second messenger mechanism. Second messenger mechanism. Fixed membrane receptor mechanism or second messenger mechanism. This group 2 hormones are further subdivided into 4 types. First type, the second messenger is cyclic AMP. For example, glucagon, then vasopressin, somatostatin, etc. Then the second messenger is calcium or phosphatidylinositol or both. For example, oxytocin, vasopressin, etc. Third type is here this protein kinase or phosphatase. For example, insulin, growth hormone, etc. Then fourth type is of the second messenger is cyclic GMP. For example, ANP, atrial natriuretic peptide. So these are the subtypes of group 2 hormones. So in the mechanism of action of group 2 hormones, this hormone receptor complex will activate a G protein. This hormone receptor complex will activate G protein. G protein means guanine nucleotide binding protein. Guanine nucleotide binding protein, and the G protein coupled receptor is known as 7 transmembrane domain receptor. 7 transmembrane domain receptor. So this group 2 hormones, as they are hydrophilic in nature, these hormones bind to cell surface receptors. This is plasma membrane, and these hormones will bind to cell surface receptors. And in the mechanism of action of these group 2 hormones, this hormone receptor complex will activate a G protein. G protein means guanine nucleotide binding protein. So this G protein, bound to either GDP or GTP. This G protein consists of 3 subunits, alpha, beta and gamma. Alpha, beta and gamma subunit. If a G protein has GDP bound to the alpha subunit, this is the inactive form. If a G protein has GDP bound to the alpha subunit, it is the inactive form. If the alpha subunit is bound to GTP, then it is the active form. So when a hormone is bind to the receptor, the G protein is inactive. It's not bound to the receptor, the G protein is inactive. When it is bound to the receptor, this G protein will be active. That is G protein. And the G protein coupled to receptor is known as seven transmembrane domain receptor. This is the seven transmembrane domain receptor of G protein. It has seven domains. So when a hormone is not bound to the receptor, G protein is inactive. And when a hormone is bound to the receptor, the G protein is activated. And this activated G protein means it has GTP bound to alpha. When the hormone binds to this receptor, this G protein will be activated and this beta gamma subunit is released. This beta gamma subunit, it will be released. Beta gamma subunit will be released and this GDP, it will be converted to GTP. This is the active form of this G protein. So this activated G protein can activate adenylate cyclase, adenylate cyclase then phospholipase C then phosphatidyl inositol calcium cyclic GMP etc. So this activated G protein can activate these all. So let's see the mechanism of action. So in the mechanism of action, first one, the cyclic, the second messenger is cyclic AMP. So the second messenger is cyclic AMP. Here the activated G protein means when a hormone binds to the receptor, that is the G protein coupled receptor, the G protein is activated and the GDP will become GTP, that is the activated G protein. So the activated G protein activate and this time beta gamma subunit is released. So this activated G protein activates adenylyl cyclase. It will activate adenylyl cyclase. This adenylyl cyclase enzyme catalyzes the conversion of ATP to cyclic AMP. It will catalyze the conversion of ATP to cyclic AMP. And this cyclic AMP can activate inactive protein kinase to active protein kinase. See, cyclic AMP can activate inactive protein kinase to active protein kinase. This protein kinase is a tetrameric molecule. It is a tetrameric molecule. It has four subunits. Two catalytic subunits and two regulatory subunits, that is R2C2. This R2C2 is inactive. So this when the cyclic AMP binds with the R2 subunit, there will be dissociation of this R2 and C2, and this C2 causes the activation of protein kinase. So inactive protein kinase means R2C2. It is a tetrameric molecule. Two regulatory subunits and two catalytic subunits. When the cyclic AMP binds with R2 subunit, there will be dissociation occurs and C2 and R2. This C2 causes the activation of protein kinase. So here it is C2. It will activate protein kinase. Inactive protein kinase to active protein kinase. This active protein kinase transfer a phosphate group from ATP to a substrate. So this active protein kinase, it will transfer a phosphate group from this ATP to a substrate molecule, and this process is known as phosphorylation. phosphorylation. For example, this protein to phosphoprotein. It will convert protein to phosphoprotein. And this phosphoprotein will show the response. Phosphoprotein will show the response. So this is the mechanism of action. After this, phosphodiesterase enzyme, phosphodiesterase, this enzyme inactivates this cyclic AMP and the cell's response is turned off. Then new hormones will bind to the receptors and the cycle continues. So that is the mechanism of action in the case of second messenger cyclic AMP. So here the activated G protein activates adenylate cyclase or adenylyl cyclase. This enzyme catalyzes the conversion of ATP to cyclic AMP. Then this cyclic AMP activates inactive protein kinase to active protein kinase. This protein kinase is a tetrameric molecule having two regulatory subunits and two catalytic subunits, that is R2C2. This R2C2, it is inactive. The cyclic AMP binds with this R2 subunit and dissociation occurs as C2 and R2. Then this C2 causes the activation of this protein kinase, inactive to active protein kinase. Then this active protein kinase, it can transfer a phosphate group from ATP to a substrate. For example, protein to phosphoprotein. It will transfer a phosphate group from ATP to protein and it will form this phosphoprotein. And this phosphoprotein will show the response. Then the enzyme phosphodiesterase inactivates the cyclic AMP. And the cell's response is turned off. Then new hormones will bind to the receptors in the plasma membrane. So that is the mechanism. Then in this second type, that is second messenger is calcium or phosphatidyl inositol or both. Calcium or phosphatidyl inositol or both. Calcium or phosphatidyl inositol or both. Here it is GDP. First it will be GDP, that is inactive form. So when hormone will bind with the receptor on the cell surface, it will form, it will activate the G protein and it will become GTP and the beta gamma subunit is released. Beta gamma subunit is released. This activated G protein leads to the activation of phospholipase enzyme, phospholipase C. It will activate phospholipase C. This phospholipase C causes the conversion of PIP2 to inositol triphosphate and diacylglycerol. It will convert PIP2. PIP2 means phosphatidyl inositol 4,5-biphosphate. Phosphatidyl inositol 4,5-biphosphate. That is PIP2. So this phospholipase C converts phosphatidyl inositol 4,5-biphosphate to inositol triphosphate, that is IP3 and diacylglycerol. IP3 and diacylglycerol. Then this diacylglycerol, it can activate protein kinase C. It can activate protein kinase C. This protein kinase C then phosphorylates specific enzymes and other proteins to modulate their activities. It can phosphorylate specific enzymes and other proteins. And these phosphoproteins will show the response. And in the case of this inositol triphosphate, this inositol triphosphate enhances the mobilization of calcium into the cytosol from intracellular calcium pool. From intracellular calcium pool to cytosol. So this IP3, inositol triphosphate, enhances the mobilization of calcium from intracellular calcium pool to the cytosol. And the effects of calcium are mediated through its binding to calmodulin or troponin. So calcium calmodulin complex or with troponin. So that is the mechanism of action in the case of second messenger, calcium or phosphatidyl inositol or both. Here phospholipase C, the activated G protein will bind to activate phospholipase C. Phospholipase C causes the conversion of phosphatidyl inositol 4,5-biphosphate to diacyl glycerol and inositol triphosphate. This diacyl glycerol, it activates protein kinase C. Then this protein kinase C then phosphorylate specific proteins or enzymes to modulate their activities. This inositol triphosphate enhances the mobilization of calcium from intracellular calcium pool to cytosol. And the effects of calcium are mediated through its binding, the calcium binding to calmodulin or troponin. Then third one is kinase or phosphatase. The second messenger is kinase or phosphatase. So here binding of insulin, growth hormone, prolactin, oxytocin, etc. to their receptors. This is the binding site. So binding of these hormones to the receptors activates specific protein kinase called tyrosine kinase. It will activate specific protein kinase known as tyrosine kinase. This tyrosine kinase phosphorylates tyrosine residue of specific proteins. It will phosphorylate tyrosine residue of specific proteins. And this causes some biochemical response. So that is in the case of kinase or phosphatase. Kinase or phosphatase. Here binding of these hormones, for example insulin, growth hormone, etc. to their membrane receptors activates specific protein kinase known as tyrosine kinase. This tyrosine kinase enzyme phosphorylates tyrosine residue of specific proteins. This causes some biochemical response. Then fourth type is the second messenger is cyclic GMP. For example, atrial natriuretic peptide. So this is about the mechanism of action of group 2 hormones. This is today's topic. Thank you for watching.